about. Tail of the tape. Hanze Howe is 27. Asa, veteran at 33. Han is 1 inch taller and about 4 pounds heavier. That's why this is a catchweight bout. Ripley. She was named after the Aliens movies from many years ago. And said, I love that lead character, Sigourney Weaver, of course, being the actress. Love that lead character so much, so he named his daughter Ripley. Asa, 10 pound, the American. Hanze Howe, three-minute rounds of Muay Thai here. It's a catchweight bout. Body kick there landed from Asa, 10 pound, followed by the push kick. Trying to go up top. What a counterattack there early from Hanze Howe.
Nice lean back counter on that one. Good reaction time coming from Hanze Howe early. And to Rich's keys to victory, Hanze Howe is mixing in those leg kicks. Starting early, trying to soften up the legs of Asa Ten Pao.
Shot to the head there from Han. 50 seconds into this opening round.
You can see Asa's kind of got that right hand glued to his forehead, keeping the fingers nice and tight there. He said that was something he really tried to work on in establishing the long guard when he's close to Hanze Howe. So look for him to try to frame out and really try to work on covering up those holes as he digs to the body with the jabs.
Nice striking jabs from Asa.
Yeah, Hanze Howe's doing a really good job of timing Asa here. You saw those two jabs that came in from Asa, and Hanze Howe was able to kind of parry them down counter. He's found a home for the lead hook to the body.
Chin Han is Chinese. He moved to Thailand at age 15 to train, now back training in China. 27-year-old with 64 career wins. He's got 4 knockouts here in 1 championship.
And they usually come with the hands. Hanze Howe is beautiful at creating angles. He'll throw a combination, step off, has you shelled up, and then boom, starts to land with big right hands. He's got a beautiful straight right, and he likes to put people out with it.
You guys early on, Rich, going up top with some success here in this opening round.
Yeah, you saw Asa throw that last cross that he did, and Hanze Howe framed really well. Then he threw another cross and leaned back out of it. That's that frame and that defense that he uses as a measuring tool. And there's that lead hook that Hanze Howe's been timing in the first round. Another one landed there.
Big left from Han, under a minute to go opening round. Body kick from Asa.
Yeah, Asa needs to start mixing up his levels. Going to the head, going to the body, mixing in the leg shots. Hanze Howe's doing a good job of threatening different areas and changing the levels.
Han takes to the body after the headshot. Goes to the knee to the body. And then a spinning back kick from Asa, 10 pounds. This is entertaining in the opening round for both men.
Good mixing up the shots coming from Hanze Howe, and Asa Ten Pao says, I can do that too. You can see the markings on Hanze Howe's body and the legs and that right there, that liver. You can see beautiful stepping elbow is again, Asa Ten Pao tries to spin.
How good is this opening round, final seconds? And Asa Ten Pao and Hanze Howe.
But I would say that by them checking on him, they were probably a bit confused about it. He was most likely not executing exactly the game plan that they had talked about.
You've been in that situation, Rich, where your corner is wondering what you might be thinking in terms of execution?
Absolutely not. 100% executed according to whatever my coach has wanted me to do every single time.
Do you believe that, Mitch?
I completely believe that. Rich Franklin is one of the few athletes that would probably listen to his coach at least 85% of the time.
Mitch must be in a good mood today.
Well, he was coaching us today, I'll tell you that. Getting us ready, getting us over here. He was driving a hard bargain, the Hall of Famer, Rich Ace Franklin was.
Like Asa Ten Pao when he goes forward, man. If he pushes Hanze Howe on the back foot, he's really doing good work with that boxing.
That's what I was talking about, Mitch, about that forward pressure. He needs to mix that in. See, these two guys right now, they're standing right in front of each other. So this becomes a timing issue. And right there, a double jab that was unnecessary to land. And Asa follows it up with a right hand.
But then the counterattack by Han. Two.
Hanze Howe forcing him to the knee. There's that 8 count. That's going to score really well. Going to automatically score a 10-8 round if this thing finishes in the second. But Hanze Howe said he's going to get a KO here in the second. But Asa Tempao landed a clean right hand.
This combination there after the inside leg kick from Asa. You see a lot of redness on the face, particularly the nose of Hanze Hao here.
Yeah, but look at those angles that he's creating. They're beautiful, man. Those little step-offs. He throws something and boom, he's stepping off. And then he's coming right back with something else. Asa Tempao trying to go airborne with the downward elbow.
Flying downward elbow. Counterattack from Han. Big left to the face there from Asa Tempao.
Yeah, you can, Asa Tempao is landing with some authority on these shots. You can see how he's busted up the nose of Hanze Hao. Hanze Hao wearing a little bit of damage. Looks like he's also wearing...
Yeah, Asa just got to be careful. He threw that inside leg kick there, just throwing those single strikes like that. He's doing his best work every time he puts these combinations together, punching two or three at a time.
Man, there is something heavy on Asa Tenpao's jab in this fight. You see blood coming from the nose of Han. Mutual respect here off the shortstop. 30 seconds in round two.
Yeah, this is a good round for Tenpao.
Tenpao in the blue gloves, Hanze Hao, China in the red gloves. 20 seconds, round two. Nice right from Hanze Hao, power attack and a combination. Huge combination to clean the uppercut from Asa. Left, right, left, straight right, flying in.
Nice.
Flying back kick, spinning Asa Tenpao, showing everything.
I'm beginning to wonder if this could possibly end up being a 9-8 round because Asa...
Take a look at this. Look at that beautiful fade back and then that short check left hook forcing Tenpao to his knees. Beautiful shot landed by Hanze Hao. But then Asa Tenpao said, I need to get this round back. And he really started to pour it on there in that final minute of the second round. Really showing aggressive hands, finishing with a spinning back kick. Looking pretty out there is Asa Tenpao.
Well, I'm thinking 9-8 round with you, Rich, as well, based on what we saw with the knockdown, but then Asa coming back so strong.
Yeah, I'll tell you, you know, in my keys of victory, I was talking about Hanze Hao's frame and the way that he doesn't take a whole lot of damage typically, and that has completely gone out the window in this particular match.
Third and final round, catchweight Muay Thai, our second fight of nine here tonight, with a world title fight to come between Nango and Jonathan Haggerty.
Asa Tenpao is hitting hard, Rich, and Hanze Hao is absorbing a lot of damage by standing right in front of him. He's usually much more evasive.
Yeah, see, Asa in this round is not staying in the pocket the whole time. He threw those two combinations, slid back out. It only takes just a couple inches to be out of range.
Big combinations, uppercut.
The second he came back, Hanze Hao is protesting, saying I was fine. But when that mouth guard popped out, referee Bomb jumped in to call the fight.
I could make a case for Hanze Hao if I was in his corner that that should have at least been a standing eight count.
Seventh knockout in the career of the American Asa Tenpao.
From a man who's never been knocked out, Brent. You said it at the top.
Hanze Hao knocked out for the first time in his career at the hands of that man.
Look at this. Asa throwing the jab out, smacking the head back, coming right back. First two weren't there. He resets, loads, and boom, right across the chin. And then he just started to pour it on, had him hurt. Jumped all over him, started swinging for the fences, trying to get Hanze Hao out of there. At this point, referee Baum saw enough. Hanze Hao, slight protesting right there. Like Rich said, could have been a case for an early stoppage, but not our call to make. The win goes to Asa Tenpao.
For the particulars, once again, Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Wacharin Ratchanapom, has called a stop to this contest after 52 seconds in the third round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Asa Tenpao!
third round TKO, Asa Tenpao out of West Palm Beach.
What a great performance, particularly after he was dropped in the second round there. This is